Here's the punter, Jake Bailey, ready to do the honors.
And we are underway in Foxborough.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Okay, great.
This is Cordarrelle Patterson. Remember, he won a ring with the Pats.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Now left side on the swing. And oh, right away, he lost the football.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them all. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Yeah, this is only going to be a gain of two. He needed three. It's fourth and one. To punt on fourth down, here's Rigoberto Sanchez. He'll field this at the five. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Pats will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10.
Here we go, here we go.
They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And he takes us across the 15 to the 17. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Here's Hurts to throw. And he's taken down. Back at his own seven. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense. So he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Well, that's not the way you want to start. A first pass attempt and a first drop all in one.
Well, you've got plenty of time to make up for it, but obviously not the way you want to get things started. Got to shake that off and get going.
This is fielded at the 27. Oh, that's just not fair, and now room to run. He'll be hard-pressed to match that one. That a 65-yard punt. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. So good field position for the Bills as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. Beginning on the ground with Patterson. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now back to throw. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
A nice completion there for the first down. And Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week one. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent. Kyler Murray with the Cardinals. The best part about his game, had his team run the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles after having started from day one.
Let's go. On play action, they'll throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Toward the sideline, it's complete. An athletic grab, but still well short of the first. Out is Rigoberto Sanchez on fourth down to punt this thing. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive.
And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
7 yards there and a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. Multiple players getting home there for an 8-yard loss.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
Drop 50.
Throwing on second and long. Hurts. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Pretty nice gain on the scramble. Gets him 12 yards. I thought they were going to sack him there like they did on first down. Great coverage, but he found a way to move with his legs.
Yeah, his ability to take off. Not only did he get some yardage back, he got a little bit extra. Really helps him on third down. Makes it manageable now.
Start of the second quarter from Foxborough. It's the homestanding Patriots with the football, as they've got it with a third down coming up. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And this is going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. Jake Bailey on now to punt here on fourth down. And that hits at the 6 and carries into the end zone for a touchback. And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
Ready.
And partner, I know so far, and we're still in the first half, but you love this game as a defensive guy. 0-0. We'll see if the offense can get going on this drive.
Well, you know how they talk about music to your ears? How about what it does for your eyes when you watch something like this, right, where these teams are locked in and going at it, no points going up on the scoreboard. I'm loving it. You're exactly right.
Well, switch over, though, to an offensive mindset for a moment. What do they need to do here to get on track and get some points?
Well, I think a couple of ways. Number one, you pull out something that maybe they haven't seen before. Coaches always talk about unscouted looks. Maybe you give them something that they haven't seen on tape, and now you shock them that way. The second, run your basic playbook, but run it so well that you give your skill position guys a chance to make big plays individually.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. First and 10, it's Patterson. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. To throw here. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 24-yard line. 2 minutes gone by, second quarter. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Got a man, it's Patterson complete. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line. Another completion there, and what a big moment in a young quarterback's life, that first NFL start. And Charles, obviously they want him to win games, but if they're looking at him under a microscope in this first month or so, what do you think they're hoping to see from it?
Well, for every question they'll have for him, they should have for themselves as a coaching staff, because it's not just how quickly can he learn the offense, it's what they can teach him, right? How can he build a relationship with his receivers? And, of course, how open is he to learning? And, of course, how
And he loses the football a second time. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I know a lot of defensive coaches have certain guys on their squad that they look to as drive stoppers, guys who can make big plays, interceptions, knock it free. In this case, they didn't need one. The offense supplied it for them, just dropping the ball.
Yeah, and that was after they were doing so well on this drive through the air. They go to the ground, doesn't work. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. That swung out wide to Harris. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And they're going to get the first down here across the 15-yard line.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
18 Rattler.
60 Maverick. But first down, Hurts. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. Riley Patterson now for the extra point. And he's one for one on the new year as his kick is good. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
To try again after the sack. Hurts. Got a man. It's Tyquan Thornton. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line.
Here we go. Here we go.
And they run the option here on first and 10. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Fans, a reminder, coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando for highlights and analysis and scores from around the NFL here in this opening weekend.
Let's put the coach to work.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Hurts. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
Throwing is Hurts. Oh, he's trying for Smith-Schuster, but it's intercepted. And the Bills are going to take possession of the football. And that now two interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
And you know, a lot of people look at these guys and they think to themselves that maybe possibly they're still thinking about the first one, and they probably are. I think in this case he's just trying to atone for the first interception, tried a little bit too hard, maybe forced it a bit, and instead created a second one.
And now a pause. It looks like we have a Patriot injured on the play. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. They'll drop to throw. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Rookie to rookie on the hook up there, and it's a first down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Looking for his man on the out route, and he's got Diggs. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door. They'll look to throw again. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Illegal touching. offense.
So here's the celebration. We'll see if they have something else in their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
Flushed out right. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
Here we go.
A big play, if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Back to throw again. And he will throw this one out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Riley Patterson now on for the field goal. This will be just a 21-yard attempt. Patterson's kick is good, and the Bills will add on to their lead. So they get the turnover in plus territory. The drive stalls out, but still able to get three out of that.
Yeah, we were able to see an offense and a defense kind of mix and match with each other, didn't we? Both of them trying to make sure that they have the upper hand and the advantage. Offense trying to get to the end zone. Defense, of course, trying to hold them to a field goal attempt. And it wasn't a guaranteed lock three from where they started. So, you know, the offense has to be happy to come away with those 3 points.
Jalen Hurts in the offense heading back out. He's been picked off twice in this ball game already. And he'll try to sort things out here as they begin with the first down.
19, right here. Left side 19.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Finding room at midfield. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts.
Come on.
As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Now a first down carry for Harris. Stopped short of the 25. The second effort couldn't free him. Hurts trying to hurry up the offense. On second and nine, Hurts. Now he's going to drop this down to Harris, middle of the field. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. The first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now first and 10. Back to throw. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Jalen Hurts in the final seconds of the first half. And the Patriots are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll cut it to three at 10-7. So time enough for a kickoff here. 5 seconds remaining in this first half. This fielded right at the goal line. Well, a dangerous return man showing it here. So we've reached. It looks like we'll have to wait another week to get our first halftime report of the season as we move right along to the second half.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
Fields it right around the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. For the Patriots taking over to start quarter number three. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have 3, 4, or 5, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Another try after the first down sack. Hurts. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
Taken down for the 5th time this game. Multiple defenders there to get him.
Now that's the way to start the second half. Back-to-back sacks. Whatever the halftime speech was, I hope they recorded it.
And Hurts is intercepted, his 3rd of the game. And the Bills are going to take possession of the football.
So the ball changing hands on the interception, but meanwhile here, we do have an injury on the play. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. One more time with Patterson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. Dancing to his left. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. When those extra defenders on the field, dime package, lots of speed, no space to fit in the football.
Patterson's kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. New England trotting into place on offense. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Again, it's Harris on second down. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now a stoppage here as we've got a Bill shaken up on the play. While the medical staff checks on him, we'll step aside in this week one contest. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. He's got his man, Thornton. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're gonna throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
45 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Seven pirate.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Getting nine after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard. They'll try the right side with Harris. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
First down, and they go back to Harris. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
They'll break the huddle and come up on the ninth play of this drive, needing 5 yards on third down. From the gun, it's Hurts. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Multiple defenders get to him there, and that is the sixth time he's been sacked in this ball game. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. And that will cut the lead back down to 3 at 13-10. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get 3 of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue because, you know, after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get 3? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
The Bills' offense back out onto the field. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation.
Okay, right.
They'll come to the line here, needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's 1st and 10 just outside the red zone. He'll drop to throw. And this is caught. It's Parker. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third call. Back now in Foxborough. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. On 2nd down, a run with Patterson. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. A 5-yard gain there makes it 1st and goal. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before.
Parker's got it for a Bills touchdown. 8 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Bills get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. New England's offense set to go. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. 25 yards that time. Here's Hurts to throw. Looking sideline, incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd and short, 3rd and 1. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the 1st down. On 3rd down, here's Harris. A great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps him pick up the 1st. Now, yes, a 2-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on 2nd and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the 1st down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a 2-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win. I think the best offenses love to give the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. This offense so far on 3rd down, they've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This time it's 3rd and 3. Able to hit his target. Oh, no, he lost the football. And he's got a 1st down as the tackle made at the Bills 26. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Looking to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Claypool. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? Harris is into the end zone. Touchdown, New England. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. From his end zone, Wilson. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. And the Bills getting set to go. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here, or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit, and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Out of the gun now on third down. And Diggs has it. And he's going to have a first down on a gain of about 10, and that'll take us to the two-minute warning. A nice pickup of 10 means that this drive will stay on track. Patterson, he'll try it up the middle. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
They'll go again with Patterson. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 43 yards on the ground for him now, as he's done that on 15 carries.
All right, go, officer. Green, yellow, line.
Straight ahead, Patterson. Down to the 42, second down. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts, as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice. An ambitious effort, but it's well short. And that will keep this a three-point game. Well, this